All right, well, politicians and their staff are spending more than 80% of their airfares with Qantas. The new data comes as the government comes under fire for not allowing more airline competition.
Well, let's bring in economics editor at the Australian Financial Review, John Keir. Johnny, good morning to you. Is there any doubt politicians and public servants are favouring Qantas?
Yeah, good morning, guys. Look, amid all this furor about the government blocking more competition against Qantas from Qatar Airways, it turns out themselves, the political class, are actually cementing Qantas's monopoly. I've dug into the numbers, and it turns out that federal MPs and their staff, some government departments, including the Prime Minister's, and also federal judges, spend more than 80% of their domestic airfares with Qantas, and Virgin's only capturing about 10% of those airfares. So there is an inherent bias towards Qantas in Canberra, that's for sure.
Is that bias then costing taxpayers any more?
You'd have to say it's costing millions of dollars extra a year, Sarah, because the average ticket price variance, that's the difference between the price that's paid and the next best available fare, is about $280 a ticket. And so you add that up, it adds up to a lot of money. And look, there's rules by the finance department that say that public servants are meant to get the lowest possible fare practical, that it should be good value for money. But they're able to get around this because Qantas operates more frequent flights, more routes as well. And sometimes, for example, if there's a flight leaving at 3 o'clock, the Qantas one, they say we can get that one instead of waiting for the 4 o'clock Virgin one. So there is ways around this.
Righto. Excellent story though, Johnny. Thank you.
Alarming new data from the ACCC shows that the total losses to scams this year has topped a whopping $360 million as hackers find new and creative ways to infiltrate our data.
Joining us to discuss is Today Money expert Effie Zahos. Effie, good morning to you. Is that true?
Yeah, that's just to scam wash that data. So it will be a lot more by the end of the year, and it's up until August. But they are just getting so clever. And this one actually popped in my box too. This is an ING scam, and they went out to their customers to show it. Have a look at this. This is their logos. This is their branding. It looks exactly like their deck, which probably is their deck. And this went out to term deposit, basically, to get people to put money in term deposits, which is typically pensioners would have these, or people on a fixed income. And it looks almost legit, but when I take a closer look at the interest rates, I can't find a term deposit that's paying up to 6%. So there's a red flag. But to most people, this looks legit.
Because is it that far off, though?
No, it's not, Carl. Yeah. That's the thing. They were very sneaky because they just put a little bit above what the rates are, but like, wow, this looks interesting. And of course, you click onto it, it's not theirs. And that is the risk here. And investment scams are the number one. Out of that figure you just said, Sarah, $217 million gets lost to investment scams.
That's significant, isn't it? I mean, and we're also talking about job scams here as well, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Job scams, they're a big one that have seen a huge jump. So job scams have gone up 950%. And basically, these catch out people that are looking for a second income, some cash coming through. So again, it's that click-through thing. The one you saw before was like a Eubank one. In all cases, what you need to do is don't click on these links. So NAB was the first to come out. And this makes sense. Why are banks sending us texts that we're supposed to click on, then give us advice not to click on? Yeah. So it's nice to see NAB and Eubank actually take the lead on that.
There are giveaways there all the time. I mean, I kind of know which ones they are, but there are people out there who are just not going to know.
Carl, I got one the other day. So I haven't put my holiday leave in, but this is planning for next year and saving. On bookings, and a lot of people use bookings because you don't have to pay for it up front. You book your hotel. So I booked that. Then I got an email through bookings and a personal one saying, hey, your card's been compromised. You will lose your booking within 24 hours if you don't go in and fix it up.
Yeah.
Now that's a big red flag. So what worries me is someone has gone through, used the same hotel where I'm staying at, make it look like a panic situation. I'm going to use my booking.com reservation, when really you don't pay for it until you go there.
It's just getting more and more difficult, isn't it, to tell. So it'll get to the point where we're just not doing anything.
And probably
which suits
that's
me, but
but that is the problem.
That's what I do. Don't answer anything. Don't click on anything. If they want me, they'll find me.
Well, what happens if you're overdue on an actual payment, though? I mean, is it a real threat?
It is.
Look, I just got one this morning from supposedly CommBank. The red flag was that it was a government payment that's owing to me.
Yeah.
If a government owes me payment, I'll fall off this chair.
We all will. All right. Just keep your eyes open. Good on you. Thank you.